Now we will discuss about the rancidification of oils. See, on this is the experience by many of the families. You and me have experienced this. What? On a long storage and in a contact with, say, air, moisture, sunlight, these oils and even the fats undergo decomposition and start smelling unpleasant. So whatever the oils we are using at home or whatever the fats we are using at home, majorly not for fat but for oils, this is our experience, that if the oil, if we kept it, if the bottle of the oil is kept it open for air or for moisture or sunlight for a long time, for a long period, at that point in time, what is happening, you know, that oil started smelling unpleasant. This process is known as rancidification. I repeat, what is this process? Is rancidification. Oil is said to be rancid oil, the oil with the unpleasant smell because of the exposure to the light, air, you know, moisture for a long period of time. That we call it as a rancid oil, and the process we are calling it as a rancidification. Please understand, what is rancidification? On long storage and exposure to air, light and moisture, the oil will develop a unpleasant smell by undergoing the decomposition reaction. That we call it as the rancidification. Now, why this or how this rancidification takes place, or how the oil turned rancid oil? By oxidation. Please understand, oxidation of unsaturated fatty acids which are present in that oil, which brings about the convert the oil into rancid oil. In presence of light and moisture, small amount of unsaturated acid which is present in fats or oil. See, oils are actually the glycerides. The oils are the esters. Even though they are esters, there is some possibility that there is small amount of fatty acid which is left in the sense of what? Which is there in a fatty acid form, not in a glyceride form. Got it? So in the oil, the small amount of free fatty acid which is present, that will undergo oxidation. That will oxidize by air to form peroxides, which further break down into aldehyde, and that aldehydes are having unpleasant smell, even unpleasant taste also. Now please understand, are you getting me? What I am explaining to you, that the oil is there, oils are triglycerides. Okay, perfect. Now these oil do contain small amount of free fatty acids in it, free fatty acids, and oil contain unsaturated fatty acids. This unsaturated fatty acid will undergo oxidation to form peroxides, and this peroxide will further break down into aldehyde, and the aldehyde which is formed in that oil is having the unpleasant smell, unpleasant odor, unpleasant taste. This is the rancidification, right? So saturated fatty acid do not get rancid. Understand, that is the very reason you can keep fat for a long time, butter you can keep it for a long time. Even you and me, we are using, you know, ghee in our food, toop. So that we can keep it for long time. But if you are using oil, that oil you cannot keep it for very long time because of the problem of rancidification. Please understand, this problem can be checked by adding small quantity of antioxidant. Generally phenolic substances are added in the oil. So whatever the oils you are using, cooking oils, I'm talking about cooking oils, in that cooking oil some phenolic substances are added as a antioxidants. You check the label of oils, if you are using or if you are bringing canned oils, canned cooking oils, coconut oil, soybean oil, or even the rice bran oil, whatever the oil you are using, you check on the label, you will get a phenolic substance. You know, phenolic substances are used, even some more other antioxidants are used, but ultimately there is a presence of antioxidant. Why they are adding antioxidants? To avoid rancidification. You got that? So this is what the oxidation of the unsaturated acid. Similarly, there is something which is called as a enzymatic hydrolysis. Due to the presence of microorganisms, fats get hydrolyzed by enzymes to produce fatty acids having sour taste and unpleasant odor. Sour taste, unpleasant odor in fat, if you find it out, that is because of the enzymes from the microorganisms. For example, butter. Butter get rancid due to production of what? You know that butter contains what? Butyric acid, right? So butter gets rancid due to the production of butyric acid. Now, how that butyric acid is getting out of the butter in small quantities? Because of the microorganisms. Please understand, these microorganisms hydrolyze, they are having the microorganisms are having the hydrolyzing enzymes in it, and they produce the fatty acids, and these fatty acids will bring about the to butter. If you have seen, if you keep the butter for long time, even in the fridge, if you are keeping the butter for long time, this free fatty acids get separated by the microorganisms, and they are causing the unpleasant odor. And unpleasant odor is okay, but especially the sour taste of butter is because of this only. Even the fats, we are talking about the fats, butter we are talking about, the fats are having the saturated fatty acids which undergo the rancidification. The saturated acids undergo beta oxidation to form the keto acid. Check this reaction. In the rancidification, only this one reaction I have pointed out here, that is the in the rancidification reaction, that the fats, the saturated acids, undergo beta oxidation to form keto acids, which gives the carbon dioxide to form the ketones. Ultimately, you will find the ketones, and that ketones are having the very unpleasant odor. Very unpleasant water. See, the caprylic acid is there. Here is a caprylic acid which undergoes beta oxidation. Beta oxidation, where we have seen this beta oxidation? In biochemistry. In biochemistry, we have discussed the beta oxidation of fatty acid. I am not going to explain it again, but this is what caprylic acid undergoes, beta oxidation. Understand? And after beta oxidation, what is happening? Keto, check this in this. Beta keto caprolic acid. In caprolic acid, you will see the CO group is there, and after that the carbon dioxide is removed, and you will get the methyl N amyl ketones. This is the ketone, and this ketone, again, caprylic acid is present in butter, you know that, isn't it? If it is butyric acid in the butter, so due to the presence of microorganisms, the enzymes which are in the microorganism, they are producing the butyric acid, sour taste, isn't it? Same way, the caprylic acid which is present in the butter, what it is happening is, it undergoes the beta oxidation to form the beta keto caprolic acid, and by the removal of this carbon dioxide, you will get ultimately the methyl N amyl ketones. So this is nothing but the ketone, and this ketone, after the release of carbon dioxide, which is having a very unpleasant odor in it. So this is the important reaction, which is important, that is the rancidification of oils.